When it comes to nutrition and bone health, there's quite a bit written about alkaline diets, a diet that's high in fruits and vegetables and low in saturated fats. But what I'd like to talk about today, specifically, is some recent research that looked at an important mineral and an important vitamin when it comes to bone health. So let's start with vitamin D. In the spring of 2010, the Journal of the American Medical Association published an article that had just over 2,000 women in the average age 76 years of age, and they were given mega doses of vitamin D once a year over a 3 to 5 year period. So mega doses, 500,000 international units once a year. What this study found was that these women actually had an increased fracture risk. Medical Advisory Committee from Osteoporosis Canada had a couple of theories in regards to the increased risk of fractures. One of them was that the enzymes that are needed to break down the active vitamin D were being produced at too great a level. Another theory was that people were feeling so good about having all that vitamin D and their muscle function was working so much better that they were all of a sudden just being that much more active, and that might have increased the risk of fractures. The main outcome of this study was that although vitamin D is a fat-soluble vitamin, we shouldn't be recommending to our clients that they take all their vitamin D in one day of the year, but rather getting it the way nature intended, a little bit every day. So the recommendations in Canada still stand between 800 and 2,000 international units a day. As far as calcium, there is a study that was published in the British Medical Journal in the summer of 2010. It was actually a meta-analysis, and this meta-analysis looked specifically at calcium supplementation alone in women, and it was quite alarming because they found that women that were taking high calcium supplementation had a significant increased risk of heart attacks. And so the recommendation is that calcium should not be taken alone because vitamin D helps with the absorption of calcium. Another recommendation in Canada was that the recommended levels of 1,500 milligrams per day for the adult population over the age of 50 was reduced to 1,200 milligrams a day. And so far as pharmaceuticals, as healthcare professionals, it's very important for us to be aware of the different medications that our clients are on and the effect that it has, when we're talking about osteoporosis, on their bone health. And so there are a lot of bisphosphonates. If you listen to any of the commercials around the 6 o'clock news, you're going to be bombarded by commercials on different bisphosphonates. And not all bisphosphonates are created equal. Some bisphosphonates protect against vertebral fractures, some against non-vertebral fractures, and some against both. Now, all these bisphosphonates are not created equal, and so it's important that you be aware, and that's one thing we go into in more detail in the Mueller Guide course, is the type of bisphosphonates that are available on the market. At the 2010 American Society of Bone Mineral Research that was held in Toronto, there was an interesting study that was presented looking at bisphosphonates and their ability to stay within the skeleton and slowly release over time in individuals who had been on bisphosphonates for some time. In this study, they found that resigernate was a bisphosphonate that did not stay in the system, so they did not detect any resigernate in the urine even after 19 months of cessation. Alendronate, on the other hand, did stay within the body. So within these type of bisphosphonates, some of your clients can go on what they call drug holidays, whereas some cannot. Tomorrow, I'm going to share with you some stories on how myself and other health professionals integrate Mueller Guide into our practice and how it can help you in your practice.